सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू फाइव इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज। एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस थ्री क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द करंट अफेयर्स व्हाइल टू क्वेश्चंस विल बी फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट स्कीम पार्ट। ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन, एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेज एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डेली सेशन, और इसका जो लिंक है दैट यू विल गेट इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच इज अबाउट अ रिपोर्ट। सो इन टुडे सेशन गाइज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टू डिफरेंट रिपोर्ट्स, वन इज दिस एंड अदर इज विल डिस्कस लेटर, एंड थ्री क्वेश्चन विल बी बेस्ड ऑन दीज टू रिपोर्ट्स एंड टू क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट स्कीम। ओके सो द क्वेश्चन इज कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग UNCTAD द लीस्ट डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज रिपोर्ट 2020 and you have to identify the correct statements regarding this report. Okay, so let's talk about the report first, and you have to remember the complete title of the report also, and the complete title is what? The Least Developed Countries Report 2020 Productive Capacities for the New Decade. Okay, aapko isko cram karne ki zarurat nahi hai, bilkul ratta maarne ki zarurat nahi hai, just aapne abhi ek baar dhyan agar aapne padh liya acche se to you will be able to recall in the exam. Okay, so this is the complete title of this report, and remember it has been released by UNCTAD, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, which was established in the year 1964. It is headquartered in Geneva. Okay, and talking more about the report, so these are the three criteria. This report is based on guys three criteria, which are per capita income, human assets index, and then we have economic and environmental vulnerability index. So these are the three criteria जिसके ऊपर ये report based है. All right. Now talking more about this report, so these are the key highlights. So according to this report, guys, the very important factor, the very important fact from this report is that pandemic has pushed 32 million into the extreme poverty in the least developed countries. And remember, this report only talks about the least developed countries. And remember one more thing, that India is not among these least developed countries. Okay, because India is a developing country, it is not the least developed. So according to this report, pandemic has pushed 32 million people into the extreme poverty in the least developed countries. Also, this is the worst economic performance of the 47 least developed countries since the third world debt crisis of 1980s. जो 1980 के दशक में जो third world debt crisis हुआ था, ये उससे भी ज्यादा खराब performance है in 47 least developed countries का. Okay. And LDCs मतलब remember least developed countries, इनके जो GDP है वो गिर गई है by 2.6% in the financial year 2021. So in the financial year 2021, the GDP of least developed countries fell by 2.6%. Okay, and extreme poverty rates in these countries will rise from 32.5 to 35.7%. Okay, जो extreme poverty के rates हैं वो बढ़ जाएंगे from 32.5 to 35.7. Okay. So these are some guys basic facts from this report, and that's it. इसमें आपको इससे ज़्यादा नहीं पढ़ना. Just remember there are three criteria, and 32 million people were pushed into extreme poverty. उनका GDP 2.6% से कम हो गया था. That's it. And now let's come back to the question. We have to find the correct statement. So pandemic has pushed 42 million people into extreme poverty. So guys, is that 42 million? No, it is not 42. It is 32 million. So this statement, guys, is incorrect. This report is based on 10 criteria. So are there 10 criteria? 10 तो नहीं है, अभी हमने पढ़े कितने क्राइटेरिया है? 3 क्राइटेरिया. So there are 3 criteria of this report. Now LDC's GDP fell by 2.6% in financial year 2021. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Their GDP will fell already fall by 2.6% in the year financial year 2021. All right. Which means we have only one statement correct here. Option E, only 3 will be the correct answer. And now guys, let's move on to question number 2. So question number 2 and 3 both are based on this report, State of Tax Justice 2020. So let's first talk about this report. So this report, guys, has been released by Tax Justice Network. Okay, Tax Justice Network in partnership with Global Alliance for Tax Justice and Public Services International. So you have to remember the name of all the organization because it is a first of its kind report. Okay, इस तरीके की report पहली बार आई है, और इसमें दो indexes भी हैं जिनके बारे में आगे पढ़ेंगे. So, State of Tax Justice 2020, these three organizations has launched in collaboration with each other, and these are some preliminary facts. So, the report examines both corporate tax and private tax evasion. जो भी corporate tax और private tax evasion है, दोनों को examine करता है report. And according to this report, there is a whopping loss of $427 billion in the terms of tax. ठीक है, total tax की terms में $427 billion का नुकसान हुआ है पूरी दुनिया में. एंड अगर हम इंडिया की बात करें तो 10.3 बिलियन पर एनम का नुकसान हर साल होता है इन आर कंट्री. ओके एंड G20 कंट्रीज अकाउंट फॉर 26.7% ऑफ द ग्लोबल टैक्स इवेशन. दैट इज ऑल्सो वेरी ह्यूज नंबर बिकॉज देर आर ओनली 20 कंट्रीज विच आर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग मोर देन 25% टू द ग्लोबल टैक्स इवेशन. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो अ ह्यूज नंबर. एंड गाइज दीज आर द टॉप 5 कंट्रीज विच आर बिगेस्ट टैक्स लूजर्स विच आर USA, UK, जर्मनी, फ्रांस एंड ब्राजील. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द बिगेस्ट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर्स टू द अदर कंट्रीज टैक्स लॉसेज, ऐसी कंट्रीज जो दूसरी कंट्रियों का टैक्स का नुकसान कराती है, उनमें से टॉप 5 कौन सी है? केमैन आइलैंड्स, UK, द नीदरलैंड्स, लग्जमबर्ग एंड यूनाइटेड स्टेट इज ऑल्सो एट द नंबर 5. ओके वेल यूनाइटेड स्टेट इज वन ऑफ द टॉप, इज इनफैक्ट द टॉप बिगेस्ट टॉप कंट्री हु इज द टैक्स लूजर. इट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर इन द अदर कंट्रीज टैक्स लॉस ऑल्सो. ओके and these are some guys India specific facts. So according to this report, remember one thing that's very important fact, that this report tells us that India's GDP is how much? $2.51 trillion. okay, this report, according to this report, India's GDP is how much? $2.51 trillion. and in India there is a tax evasion loss of 0.41% of our GDP. हमारे GDP का 0.41% जो है वो tax evasion के loss में चला जाता है. and मॉरिशस, सिंगापुर एंड नीदरलैंड्स, दीज कंट्रीज कॉज द मैक्सिमम लॉस टू द कंट्रीज इन टू इंडिया इन टर्म्स ऑफ टैक्स लॉस. ओके जो ये 3 कंट्रीज है, मॉरिशस, सिंगापुर और नीदरलैंड्स, इससे हमें इनसे हमें सबसे ज्यादा टैक्स का नुकसान होता है. एंड दीज आर द 2 इंडेक्स, वन इज फाइनेंशियल सीक्रेसी इंडेक्स एंड अदर इज कॉर्पोरेट टैक्स हेवन इंडेक्स 2020 विच वर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस रिपोर्ट इटसेल्फ. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स टॉक अबाउट फाइनेंशियल सीक्रेसी इंडेक्स. So it measures the degree of freedom available to the defaulters. ये वो measure करता है जो defaulters को कितनी freedom मिली हुई है कौन से country में to commit tax defaults and evasions by hiding their financial assets. मतलब कौन से देश में जो defaulters है उनको कितनी freedom है कि वो अपने assets को छुपा सकते हैं और अपने taxes को evade कर सकते हैं and then finally वो defaulter बन सकते हैं. Okay? And there were total 133 countries जिनके indexes इसमें लिए गए. And among them, Cayman Islands was at number 1. मतलब Cayman Islands में सबसे ज्यादा freedom है to the defaulters ताकि वो tax evade कर सके, because वहाँ पे बहुत जो laws हैं उतने ज्यादा stringent नहीं है. India was at 47th rank and OECD countries account for 49% of financial secrecy in the world. Okay? And talking about the next index, that is Corporate Tax Haven Index 2020. So there were total 64 countries जिनका ये index बनाया गया है. First, it is British Virgin Islands and it measures a country's complacency in allowing tax evasion by acting as tax havens. Okay, and I hope you all know what are tax havens. Write down in the comments what is the meaning of tax havens. UK is responsible for over a third of the world's corporate tax abuse risk. Alright, so these are the 2 index that were included in this report. Financial Secrecy Index 2020 and Corporate Tax Haven Index 2020. You have to remember this. And guys, this report is very, very important if you talk about the RBI exam because it is related to tax and it is a first of its kind report. Okay, so pay attention to this report. And now let's move on to the question number 2 and 3. So question number 2 says we have to consider these statements and we have to identify the incorrect statements. Okay, remember you have to find the incorrect statement. So there was a loss of $427 billion globally. Yes, this is absolutely correct. There was a loss of $427 billion. In India, there is a loss of $10.3 billion per annum. Yes, guys, this is also absolutely correct. India mein $10.3 billion per annum ka loss hai. And India's ranking in financial secrecy index is 47th. This is also correct, guys. Which means the correct answer should be none is incorrect. Option D, none is incorrect, will be the correct answer. And talking about question number 3, which of the following countries is the biggest tax loser in the State of Tax Justice 2020 report? So this country, guys, this country is United States of India. Matlab option D, USA will be the correct answer. And this country is also one of the contributors to the other country's tax loser. It is at number 5 in that case. Okay. And now, guys, let's move on to question number 4 and 5, which are based on government schemes. So there is a passage given in this question. You have to identify the scheme after reading this passage. And as I told you, there are various hints जो कि हमें passage में मिलते हैं. You just have to identify those hints and mark the answer. Okay? So a scheme was launched by erstwhile Ministry of HRD, which is now Ministry of Education, and which is of course headed by Dr. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank. Dr. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank, his Lok Sabha constituency is Haridwar. So it was launched in the year 2018 to promote research and academic collaboration with foreign universities. So the basic objective is given, the ministry is given, and the launch year is given. Three things are already given to you. Under the scheme, faculties from foreign universities visit the Indian universities. Okay, one more thing is given. And the budget provided depends on the visiting time of the foreign faculty. So I think a lot of things are given in this paragraph, and these are the options. So if you have heard of all these schemes, you can identify the correct scheme, which scheme in this passage we are talking about. Okay, let me give you one more hint. In this scheme, IIT Kharagpur is the coordinating institute. All right, now can you identify the scheme, guys? Yes, this is SPARC. Option B, SPARC is the correct answer. Scheme for Promotion of Academic and Research Collaboration. Scheme for Promotion of Academic and Research Collaboration is the full form. Correct answer is option B. And now one more question is similar to the previous question. There is also one passage which is given, and you have to identify the program. So program to provide rural entrepreneurship awareness. All right. So basic, you know, the objective is given. It is to promote the rural entrepreneurship awareness, practical experience in rural agriculture, and creating awareness to undergraduate students. So the beneficiaries are also given, undergraduate students. About practical agriculture and allied sciences was launched in 2016 by ICAR. So Indian Council of Agricultural Research is the implementing agency. Launch year, it was 2016. Under the program, monthly stipend of rupees 3000 for a maximum of 6 months is provided. 6 mahine ke liye jo maximum stipend hai wo 3000 rupees diya jata hai. And now you have to identify the program. So guys, I hope you can easily identify the program now. If you are not, then your studies, you are not studying properly, because this was also in news recently. So various things are given. 2016 mein iska launch year hai. ICAR ne isko implement kar rakha hai. 3000 ka stipend milta hai. ICAR ne kar rakha hai to ministry bhi clear ho jati hai. Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Basic hame iska objective bhi pata hai. So yes, you are absolutely right, guys. Option A, student ready, is the correct answer here. And ready stand for Rural Entrepreneurship Awareness Development Yojana. Rural Entrepreneurship Awareness Development Yojana is the full form of ready, and student ready is the correct answer to this question. Okay. So I hope, guys, you were able to answer these questions, question number 4 and 5, and all the other 3 questions also. And I hope the session is clear. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.